We are going to take a look at how the visibility and insights provided by some of the announcements Linda just shared are creating this shared context in different workflows across different IT teams that's going to enable them to all take better actions in order to deliver those exceptional customer experiences. Now, to do this, we are going to turn to our friends at Nextgen Financial. So Nextgen Financial, like many customers, is using web and mobile applications in order to deliver a number of their products and services to customers. So things like insurance quotes, loans, or online bill pay. With AppDynamics, we're collecting business metrics across each component of the application. And that's what you see on this top dashboard here. And already, I can see I'm getting a proactive yellow alert around my insurance quote, the dollar value there. It's below the baseline of what I would expect. So I want to take special attention there before we start to get into the red. Now, beneath that, I'm also capturing a number of different KPIs across those business transactions that Linda talked about, those fundamental building blocks that match the different actions that customers are taking throughout our application. And again, I can see that there's some yellow. I can see that I have some issues with my quote sent and some response time issues with that apply discount area. So two problems. In order to understand how I'm going to prioritize these, I want to take a look at the impact that these are having on my user experience. So I'm going to click into that 450K, and it's going to pop open that experience journey map. So again, this is a very new feature to the whole industry where we're able to actually map screen by screen those pathways that users are taking through the front end of the application. And we're doing this dynamically. So as those user behaviors change, this map will automatically update and allow us to make sure that we're constantly focused on those critical customer pathways. And we don't just map the journey, we're also overlaying performance data on top of this. So now for the first time, we're actually able to understand how any sort of issue on a responsiveness or performance level is actually impacting that user behavior. And in this case, I can go ahead and see that as customers are trying to apply for a discount, they're running into some latency that's causing 70% of them to drop off. Now, I also see an issue around my quotes being sent, but because this apply discount is happening upstream, I'm definitely going to go ahead and take a look and make sure that we can fix that first. So let me go ahead and navigate and get a little bit more detail in my dashboard area. So AppDynamics is collecting a lot of information here, not just about the application environment. And you can see that on the next on our dashboard over here. And what we're looking at is the health of the different application servers, but also the underlying infrastructure that's supporting the application. So again, I know something is wrong with those quote services, but because of the importance of those applied discount areas, I'm going to start there. And it looks like I have something going on with my virtual machines. Now, at this point, I'm going to need to work closely with my infrastructure team. And typically with APM tools, this is where we start to get into those silos where the application team is looking at separate data from my infrastructure team. But with AppDynamics, we're providing a much more unified view. And we're doing that with our integration with Cisco Workload Optimizer. Here, now I've switched context. I'm in that infrastructure lens. And what we're looking at here on the screen on the left-hand side is a dependency map. And this is highlighting all the different entities that my infrastructure that are supporting the application. So everything from the application servers to the VMs to the host to storage. CWOM is pulling all this information, including the app topology information from AppDynamics. And we're not just doing this for our customer-facing applications. You can see that we're actually doing this for all of our different applications in the business. But we're going to focus and stick to Nextgen Financial for now. So let's go ahead and see what's happening there. CWOM has automatically detected that based on the information that I'm getting about the application, the recommended response in this particular case is to increase my memory from 6 gigabytes to 7 gigabytes. So let's go ahead. We're going to select this action and apply. Now, back on the application side of things, I'm actually glad to see that it looks like that health is back to normal on the VMs. And from a business perspective, if I scroll down, I can see, in fact, that yes, that applied discount business transaction, back to green. The response time looks good. And actually, on our insurance quotes, we can still see that we've actually upped the dollar value there. We're at to $650K. So looking good, but obviously still yellow. So there's still some remediation that needs to be done. And next, we're going to tackle that quote service. Now, I know from the previous screen that I've solved my infrastructure problem. But so this is likely due to something happening in the application environment. So let's go ahead and dive deeper into AppDynamics. OK. Now, with this view, I'm looking at the flow map, and here I'm looking at all. Oh, okay. Sorry, I'm seeing something different on this screen, but we're all good. Okay, we are looking at the application flow map here, and this is showing all the different dependencies upstream and downstream that are supporting the application. Nextgen Financial is running in a hybrid environment. So some of these services are running on-premise, and some are running in the cloud. And in fact, if I look down at the bottom, I can see one of my services is actually taking advantage of AWS Lambda. All right, but we're here to troubleshoot. So let's go ahead and navigate to my troubleshooting area, pull up my violations and anomalies. And here I'm getting a curated list of all the different anomalies that are being pulled from Cognition Engine. So sure enough, I see first and foremost that I do have an issue with my quote services here, and it's an ongoing anomaly. So let's click into there and get to a view. Now, this with our Cognition Engine, we're using algorithms and machine learning to simplify the view and automatically populate those top suspected root causes. And in this particular case, for my quote services, I can see that I have some CPU violations with my credit check service that's causing some downstream impacts. So let's go ahead and take a deeper look and pull up a snapshot that's going to help me ensure that I'm getting the right information here. So now I've isolated, in this particular view, just the calls that are happening around my credit service functionality. And in this error, if I look very closely, I can see that, in fact, I've pulled up that there is an issue happening at the doGet method within my credit check services. And it looks like there's an arithmetic error that's occurring, a divide by zero, somewhere within line 67. Okay, so this is great from an IT ops perspective. I've been able to get down to the code level issue of what's going on. So with our integration with Jira, I'm actually able to create that ticket and kick it over to my dev team to start to remediate. Sounds good, right? Well, if you're on the dev side, it's actually a little bit more complicated than that. Very rarely do these teams have access to the production environments where this code is running. So they still need to go through additional steps in order to understand where the code is actually firing incorrectly. And oftentimes, they're trying to recreate these issues in test environments. Sometimes it's near impossible to recreate these. This is where our deep code insight functionality comes into play. All right, so I'm switching context again. Now I'm at the developer hat on. And I'm looking at a view of deep code insights. And on the main screen, what I'm seeing is all the different code that's executing live in production. All right, so I know from my Jira ticket that I need to be in the doGet method around my credit check services, and I know I'm looking for line 67. But I need more information to know how I'm going to actually write any code fix here. So I'm going to place what's called a dynamic breaking point. So it's essentially a breaking point that's not going to break the code as it's executing and running through. And I place that at line 67. And now, as you can see below, I've started to collect additional information about the different parameters that are executing at that particular line. So let's go ahead and open one of these. I'm going to open this top one here. And you can see I've actually been able to identify all the different variables that are being executed at that specific line. OK, well, I know this was an arithmetic error that was in my information from IT ops. And yes, here, in fact, I see that the coefficient is set equal to zero. Well, there you go. That's likely what's causing that error message around dividing by zero. So now this is great. I'm armed with the right information. I can go ahead and write my code fix. I'm ready to check it in. And this is where we're going to start to segue into Harness. As a developer, I can actually push this new code as a canary release. And it's going to go through an automated pipeline that consists of three stages. So first, we're going to run it through dev. Then it'll go through QA. And finally, we're going to deploy it to production. Now, this is where our integration with AppDynamics is so vital. We're actually pulling in those health rules and performance data directly from AppDynamics. And so this way, we're able to get a real-time sense of whether or not this canary release has caused any sort of performance degradation or any issue impacting my end users. But we have a good dev team here. It looks like they wrote the right code. Everything looks healthy. This also helps from an IT ops perspective, because now I know that my developers are checking in code that's not going to degrade the performance of my application. So let's go ahead and confirm that this all worked on the IT ops side. OK, back to my application dashboard. Everything's looking green. And just to go full circle, we're going to go back to that business view. And we see, in fact, all the business transactions look healthy. And my quotes, the dollars going through my quote functionality look back to the baseline. So in this quick example, we've shown how we're able to connect a number of different personas throughout the IT organization. Our application teams, our business teams, our development teams, and even into our infrastructure teams. We're using that shared visibility and insight to drive actions, all in the service of creating a superior end customer experience.